Yo, Sports Gaming Universe, what is going on? This is Popular Stranger, and thanks again, guys, for checking out another one of my videos here on SGU. Today, I'm bringing you guys a little head-to-head online gameplay for Madden Ultimate Team, and my team is rocking the Redskins jerseys in this gameplay. As you see, we started off with a terrible interception, a terrible decision, but we will get back on track, and I hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay. But what I wanted to talk about today, with Madden 25 about 3 months away, a little less than 3 months away, I've been thinking about a lot of different things, different features, different changes that they can make to Madden Ultimate Team. It is my favorite game mode, and I've played it a ton this year and last year, and I really have a nice successful series going on my channel with Ultimate Team. If you haven't checked it out, make sure you check out that link in the description down below to my channel. I have about 43 episodes of Ultimate Team gameplays, card openings, pack openings. I don't know how you can open cards. I just fumbled there. Anyway, but I put out a video on my channel recently, and I got a lot of feedback from my subscribers, and I thought I'd ask you guys on SGU the same thing. As far as Ultimate Team next year, there's a ton of different legend players that they have still not used, and I know there's certain players that they're never going to be able to use or they can't use because of licensing agreements and contracts and all that stuff. But I asked this question to you guys, and you can leave it in the comments. What legends that we have not seen in Ultimate Team yet, which ones would you like to see in next year's game? Me, personally, I'm a huge Eagles fan, and Donovan McNabb has officially announced that he'll be retiring, so I would really love for them to get him back in the game. I'd love to see Brian Dawkins back, Brian Westbrook, just amongst some of the other Eagles that are on my list there. But again, I got a ton of feedback from my subscribers, and they gave me a lot of good names, a lot of people, you know, that I didn't think about, like Bo Jackson and Thurman Thomas and Jim Kelly, just thinking off the top of my head. Mike Singletary was another one, so you guys let me know in the comments. But another thing that I really wanted to talk about, and this is an improvement that I think Ultimate Team should make, though I don't think it's going to happen, I really wish it would. I just recently started playing Diamond Dynasty in MLB 12 The Show, and if you guys like baseball gameplays as well, make sure you check out my channel for that. I'm very versatile when it comes to sports gaming. But I just dived into the Diamond Dynasty game mode, and one of the first things that I learned quickly while playing this game mode is that, and if you don't know what it is, it's basically like Ultimate Team for baseball. It's just a different game, and they have a lot of different things and techniques that they use. But one of the main things I notice is that contracts, there are no contract cards. Once you get a card, generally the player is good for 10 games, and after you use them up for the 10 games, they're gone. You lose the card, you cannot renew it. And I know a lot of you guys work hard on your position collections and, you know, just different collections to earn these huge rewards and really beastly 4-star and 3-star cards, and you would hate to lose them. But hear me out here. I really think that doing this type of thing for Madden Ultimate Team would keep this game fresh year-round. Ask yourself or answer my question. How many times have you played a head-to-head mutt game and basically played against the same team? Played against a team full of Shannon Sharps, Jerry Rices, Michael Irvins, Barry Sanders, Emmitt Smiths, Rod Woodsons, Ronnie Lotz, Deion Sanders. You know, you get my point. I'm just tired of playing against the same Ultimate Teams every time. Now, me personally, I don't have any Legends on my team. I try not to use them. I think they're somewhat overpowered, and it's okay. If that's your cup of tea, I'm fine with that. But, again, back to my original suggestion and hope, is that I think it would be really cool if that once you get a card, you use it for how many contracts it has, and then once you get it, it's gone. And again, I know a lot of you work hard on some of the cards, but I would think, you know, the positional collection rewards, you know, those really tough to obtain reward cards, maybe you can give them 75 to 100 contracts. I think that's more than enough games that you would need it for. I play a lot of Ultimate Team. I've probably played about 130 to 150 Ultimate Team head-to-head games, maybe another 50, you know, against the computer for solo challenges and things like that. So I would say your average gold cards, your average, you know, legend cards that come out, you know, from day one, give them 15 to 20 contracts. And then, you know, the bigger reward cards, give them 50, 75, even 100 contracts. But I think it would keep everything fresh. There are so many good players in the NFL. You know, it's just kind of sad when you have cards like, you know, a 99 Matt Ryan. Matt Ryan's a great NFL player, but you never see anybody in Madden Ultimate Team using that type of player. Or, you know... I'm just drawing blanks right now, but you understand my point. There's so many good players out there, so many players I like to use, but at times I just can't because it's too tough to keep up with these overpowered, crazy, super stat cards. So again, I think it would be kind of like a draft duels type thing where nobody really ever has a super superior squad, and if your cards basically... run out, then you just got it. You can either go and try to get the same card again, buy it off the auction house, try to complete the collection reward on a farm account, you know, whatever. But I think that would really keep Mutt fresh. So let me know your ideas for the next Mutt. I've been kind of compiling different thoughts, and I've made two videos on two different ideas so far, and I'm, you know, it's just something I'm looking to talk about until we actually get the next Madden Ultimate Team. So again, leave it in the comments, give me all your suggestions, and again, let me know which legends you would like to see in Madden Ultimate Team 25. So you see, we got the win here. If you don't know me, I don't like when people dive on me when they're losing in the game, so I had to let this guy know about himself. It's Popular Stranger. Thanks for watching. I'm out, guys. Peace.